Hi, this is Anastasia from AnastasiaPopova.com and CrochetForBabies.com. Thank you for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to crochet an octopus for the Octo Project. The Octo Project has originated in Denmark, and since 2013, over 21,000 of octopuses has been donated to the babies in the NICU. The reason behind this project is the octopus that helps babies, preemies in the NICU thrive. And the trick is the little tentacles. They remind babies of the umbilical cord in their mommy's womb, and it makes them feel comfortable in the surrounding of the NICU, and it helps them thrive. Let's get over what you will need to create the octopus. First, you will need the pattern. My pattern you can find at crochetforbabies.com. I created a modified pattern to the original Octo Project pattern to accommodate worsted weight yarn that's more readily available in the US. The original pattern was created to use fingering weight yarn and DK weight yarn. And another modification I did was to crochet an octopus in one piece from start to finish. The original pattern has you make the bottom piece separately and then sew it to the octopus. My pattern makes it all in one piece. You will also need the yarn. You will need worsted weight, 100% cotton yarn. I'm a big fan of, I love this cotton for this project. You can get it at Hobby Lobby. Sugar and cream is also a good choice. You can get it in any big box yarn store, like Michael's, Asimura, or Joann's, or there's also peaches and cream that you can get at Walmart. You will also need a G hook for 25mm, yarn needle, and some stuffing. So let's get started. So I'm going to start with the adjustable ring. There are many videos you can look up how to do the adjustable ring. This is just the way I do it. Now, for round one, I need 6 single crochet into the adjustable ring. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now to finish it up, I'm going to pull the short end of the tail to tighten up the ring. So I have round one done, 6 single crochet. For round two, I need to be making 2 single crochet in each stitch round. The easiest way to find your first stitch is to count back. So 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is my first stitch. So inserting the hook under 2 strands of my first single crochet. I'm going to make 1 single crochet. And then in the 101, right into the same stitch. And 2 stitches into the next stitch. Oops. 2 here. 1, 2 here. The other is a little splitty. So I went all the way around. I should have 12 stitches at this point. So I have 12 stitches in round 2. In round 3, I need to be making 1 single crochet in the next stitch and then 2 single crochet in the next one. So 1 single crochet in the next stitch, 2 single crochet in the next one. 1 single crochet in the next one, 2 in the next one, 1 here, 2 here. And then 2 here. How can you tell if you've made 1 single crochet or 2? So if you look over here, do you see there is a space and you have one single crochet coming? So you have a V here, that's one single crochet. In the next space, do you see how you have four strands, two V's? And if you look at them from kind of far, you can see how they're kind of squished at the bottom. So that tells you that there are two single crochet coming up from one spot. So now for round number four, I need to do single crochet in the next two stitches. And then two single crochet in the next one. So one single crochet here, one here, and then this stitch gets two single crochet. One, two. Okay, so at the end of round four, I should have 24 stitches. So we're going to stop increasing at this point and just continue working straight. So what I'm going to do is one single crochet in each stitch around for 5 rounds. So just one single crochet in every single stitch around. So at this point I have 9 rounds done. I have 4 rounds of increases and then 5 rounds of just going straight all the way around with one single crochet all around. Now I'm ready to do decreases, this portion of the octopus. For round number 10, I'm going to single crochet in next 2 stitches and then do a decrease, single crochet 2 together. To do that, insert the hook under 2 strands of the next stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, insert the hook under the neck, 2 strands of the next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, I'm going to yarn over and pull through all 3 of the loops I have on my hook. So single crochet 2 together, single crochet next 2 stitches, and then single crochet 2 together. Single crochet in the next 2 stitches and then single crochet 2 together. Single crochet in the next 2 stitches and then single crochet 2 together. So I'm going to do this 6 times around. 2. Okay, at this point I should have 18 stitches all around. For round number 11 and 12, I'm just going to single crochet in each stitch around. When I get to single crochet 2 together, instead of inserting the hook under 2 strands here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to split the stitch a little bit and insert the hook under this strand, the back strand of this decrease. Hope you can see it. What it lets me do is to not stretch the decrease stitch. Because as an alternative, if I do it the regular way, sometimes the single crochet 2 together tends to be a little loose, so you will end up with a hole here. To kind of prevent that, a modification is to work under the back strand here. If it's too difficult to find, you can skip that and just do the work into it the regular way. But it's worth trying to find it. It gives you a cleaner look. So I'm going to do this 2 times around. for 2 rounds. I did it once, now I'm going to single crochet all the way around second time. I'm just gonna speed it up a little bit. You can use a stitch marker to help you keep track of your rounds. I'm looking for making sure I have 2 rounds on top of a decrease. So when I get there, I know I went all the way around. It's already third. See how I have a decrease and then 1, 2, 3, so those stitches are extra. So I need to go back to here. In the next round, I need to single crochet in the next 7 stitches and then do a decrease. So I have my first 3. And then I'm going to do a decrease. And I'm going to do this one more time, and this round is done. So single crochet in the next 7 stitches, and then 2 together. After that, I'm going to single crochet all the way around one more time, and slip stitch at the end, and that would be the end of the body. I will see you to make tentacles. So I finished making the body, I have 14 rounds, and now I'm going to start making the tentacles. To do that, so I'm going to single crochet the next stitch, then I'm going to chain 40. You can do anywhere from 35 to 40, you just want to make sure that your chain is not longer than 8 inches. How big to make your chains? You don't want them to be too loose. But because that will make the curls look a little looser, not as crisp, but you don't want them to be too tight, so it's hard to work into them. So use your judgment. Okay, so how many do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. You measure it. So I'm actually almost 8 inches, so I'm just gonna keep it at 30. Starting with the third chain from the hook, so the loop on my hook doesn't count, then chain 1, chain 2, chain 3. I'm going just under the top strand, and then doing 1 single crochet, and then another one into the same space. 2 in the next one, and 2 in every single chain until I get to the end. If your chains are loose, you might want to do 3 single crochet in some of the chains just to make the curls look crispier. You can see that they're already starting to curl. So I'm inserting the hook under only one strand of each chain. You can see how the chain I'm working into kind of stretches out, but once I put the chain next to stitches into the next chain, it kind of covers it up a little bit, so it doesn't look as loose. So don't worry if you make some you stitches and it just looks very, very loose. It will even out. And that is partially why I'm suggesting kind of creating chains a little tighter. Normally we don't recommend it. Normally you want your chains to be loose for crochet projects, but when you're making curls like that, that's actually beneficial to have slightly tighter chains. I'm always at the end. As you can see, tentacles take a long time to make, and you only need eight of them. So I have lost a few chains. Two more. Last chain. So this is the single crochet I made before starting the tentacle, and to connect the tentacle to the body, I'm going to single crochet into the next stitch of the body. And then to start the next group, I'm going to single crochet into the next stitch of the body and chain, make a long chain, between 30 and 40 chains, just to make sure you have under 8 inches. So now I have body and 8 tentacles completed. The original pattern stated to fasten off at this point and do the bottom separately and then sew it together. I like to do it as one piece. So this is what I'm going to do after all of this is completed. First I'm going to do one round of single crochet, working only through the single crochet that's between the tentacles. So I have one before the first one. And then there is two between each of the tentacles. So one will go here. And then one over here. Tricky to identify them and get to them. So in this row, I will have a total of 16 stitches. You could see it's easier to identify the second single crochet, not the first. So I look for this one and then I go one step back to find the first single crochet of the pair. And as it needs to be crocheted fairly tightly, it's a little tricky getting the hook in without splitting the yarn. Okay, so this is my last stitch of this round. Now in the next round, I'm going to single crochet two together all around. So I will end up with 8 single crochet two togethers. So insert the hook onto 2 strands of the next stitch. Yarn over, pull up a loop, insert the hook onto the next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, the 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, go through all 3 strands. When I go about halfway through, I'm going to stop and stuff the body of the octopus. Okay, so I'm going to extend this loop. And I'm going to use the fiber felt to stuff the head and the body of the octopus. And I'm going to continue making single crochet two together all the way around. One more stitch to do. Alright, so now I'm going to fasten off. I'm just going to cut the yarn, leaving about 6-inch tail. And then extend the loop until the end comes out. We'll thread the yarn needle with the yarn tail that I just created. Now I'm going to insert the needle under the 2 loops of the next stitch, in and then out under the 2 loops of the other one. I'm just gonna go in and out all the way around. Just 2 strands, like you would insert the crochet hook when you're crocheting, when you're doing regular stitches. So I went all the way around. Now, the tricky part. So I'm going to pull this closed, and at the same time push the tops of the loops inside. I'm going to create a knot here. I'm just going to do a French knot. Now, I don't necessarily like how this looks. I'm going to show you a little trick how to make this pretty. So I'm going to insert the needle under 2 strands of the last row of single crochet. A single crochet two together. So the top 2 strands. I'm gonna do it all the way around. We had 8 stitches there, so I will go under 8 stitches. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Should be it. Actually, one more into the first one. Now, see as I pull it, do you see how much nicer this actually looks now? So I'm going to do another knot. Now, to hide the yarn tail, I'm just going to insert the needle into the body, come out somewhere up in the... The needle doesn't want to go. Now I'm going to pull the yarn needle a little bit, cut it, and the yarn tail will hide back inside. So here you go. This is the octopus. I hope somebody gets to enjoy it.